on now, we've come so far. I guess I'm proud. And I ain't worried about the wrinkles around my smile. I got some scars, I've been around. I felt some pain, I seen some things, but I'm here now. Those good old days.
You don't know what you got till it goes, till it's gone. You don't know what you got till it goes, till it's gone. I wish somebody would have told.
take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad.
Second, I need to get my story straight. My friends are in the bathroom getting higher than the Empire State. My lover, she's waiting for me just across the bar. My seat's been taken by some sunglasses asking about a scar. And I know.
Attention, everyone. The program will begin at 7 p.m. Thank you.
Closes and you feel like falling down, I'll carry you home tonight. We are
I graduate. Oh yeah, I just graduated high school. Ha ha. Hey, home.
Thank you. you told me, babe. Someday these will be the good old days. All the love you won't forget. And all these reckless nights you won't regret. Someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of these good old days.
I was thinking about the band. I was thinking about the fans. We were underground, loading merch in that 12 passenger van in a small club in Minnesota. And the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name in the star. Now look at where we at, still growing up. Still growing up. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I'd become. Couldn't wait to get older. Couldn't wait to be some. Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe, that someday these would be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old days.
Wish I didn't think I had the answers. Wish I didn't drink all of that glass first. Wish I made it to homecoming. Got up the courage to ask her. Wish I would've gotten out of my shell. Wish I put the bottle back on that shelf. Wish I wouldn't have worried about what other people thought. I felt comfortable with myself. Rooftop open and the stars above. Moment frozen, sneaking out and falling in love. Me, you, and that futon. We just begun. On the grass dreaming, figuring out who I was. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would've told me, babe, that someday these would be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old days.
Never thought we'd get old. Maybe we're still young. Maybe you always look back and think it was better than it was. Maybe these are the moments. Maybe I've been missing what it's about. Been scared of the future, thinking about the past while missing out on now. We've come so far, I guess I'm proud. At night, worried about the wrinkles around my smile. I got some scars, I've been around. I felt some pain, I've seen some things, but I'm here now. Those good old days.
You don't know.
The Women's Chorus would like to dedicate this song to the Farmingdale High School.
Thank you. Good evening. I'd like to introduce our Student Government Association President, Olivia Espinosa, who will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. So I'd like to call Olivia to the podium. Take your time, watch your step today, folks.
Hold on to the railings, please.
Hold on to the railings. And please remain standing for the singing of the national anthem performed by the Senior Chorale. So first, Olivia Espinosa with our Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Take your time, Liz. Good evening. It's good to have you here. I am Dr. Samuel Thompson, the proud principal of Farmingdale High School. I want to welcome you all to this momentous occasion. Welcome members of our Board of Education, our superintendent, Mr. Defendini, and members of Central Administration. Welcome our district administrators, including our two assistant principals, Ms. Arlene Martinez and Mr. Jed Herman. And I especially want to welcome our families, parents, friends, and students. I'd like to thank Mrs. Patty Ann Stallone and the administrative assistants, as well as the custodial staff for their efforts and assistance organizing this ceremony. And I'd like to thank the senior class advisor, Ms. Jackie Verry, who has made the time for this class a memorable one for you all. Thank you. Please be seated. For me, it is a great privilege and honor to welcome the class of 2021. Congratulations. An important tradition at Farmingdale is to recognize our service women and men in this graduating class. I invite these individuals to stand and be recognized. when you are called. Anthony Diaz entering the U.S. Military Academy at West Point. Please remain standing. Olivia Farquharson entering the United States Marine Corps. Madison Outing entering the United States Marine Corps. And Pimnata Tanvararak entering the United States Air Force. I'd like to note that these young women and men have chosen to serve our country in the various branches of the United States Armed Forces. These individuals have committed to protect and serve our country, and we all thank you for your service. Be safe, and we are especially proud to honor you. Please be seated. Thank you, and everyone can be seated. Thank you, I'm grateful for the opportunity to be a part of this momentous occasion. High school graduation is a tremendous accomplishment, and this is an important ceremony to mark it. I'm especially proud to honor you, the Farmingdale High School Class of 2021, as well as the parents, the faculty and staff, and the friends who have helped make this day possible. And thank you to our Farmingdale Board of Education, members and central administrators for your continued support. For a moment, let's reflect on a few lessons we've learned in the last year or so at Farmingdale High School. Canceled. These were times when you asked yourself, how much more will we have to endure? For the first time in our lives, major events we had enjoyed for years were canceled. Sporting events like the 2020 Summer Olympics, indoor and outdoor concert events, parades assembled to celebrate special days, events, or cultures, and the family gatherings for weddings or other symbolic traditions in our community were all canceled. We were forced to consider whether this would be our new normal. Virtual only. We found ways to connect through virtual-only events and an endless stream of pre-recorded videos. One of the earliest attempts at this was the pre-recorded We Are Family rendition from our administration across the district. I know. Singing in key is not a talent I possess, so I will keep my day job. We were again forced to consider whether this would be our new normal. Then a new phrase emerged. The pandemic, the weather, the spinning of the earth on its axis are all things beyond our control. The COVID protocols were also beyond our control. But through resilience and grit, we started to find ways to overcome. We endured canceled or virtual only and adopted a new phrase, despite the pandemic. This phrase is more in line with what it means to be a Daler. We pounced on the things we control and we put our intellect and our spirit on display. Our students from the class of 2021 helped lead Farmingdale High School to the ranks of the U.S. News and World Report list of the best high schools in the country. You participated in leadership conferences, such as the Long Island Leaders of Tomorrow, to help shape change. You led undefeated athletic seasons, captured conference titles and individual county titles in tennis, swim and diving, and track and field. You produced large-scale musical performances like Beauty and the Beast and The Rise of Skywalker. Life will force you to endure obstacles and challenges that your time at Farmingdale High School has prepared you to overcome. In fact, this past year, you have demonstrated that you have what it takes, and we are all here to celebrate today as proof of your resilience. As Ralph Waldo Emerson has said, not in his goals, but in his transitions, man is great. You took ownership of the things you control and transitioned through a difficult school year with success, and we are all proud of you. You will embark on a journey of lifelong learning and experiences that will continue to shape who you are and what you contribute. We owe it to ourselves to tap into the unique qualities that shape our approach to supporting the world around us. Continue to show off your intellect, your resilience, your grit, to overcome and transition through life's challenges, and you will always be successful. What you've learned at Farmingdale High School will make it possible for you to do all of that. Be resilient, and you will be successful. You are an exceptional group, and we congratulate you all and wish you the best. Congratulations. Next, I'd like to invite to the podium to speak to the class one last time, your Dean of Students, Mr. Frank Hebron.
Thank you, Dr. Thompson. Good evening, family, friends, and especially you, the Farmingdale High School class of 2021. I love you too. So I've had the distinct pleasure of serving as dean of this class for the past 7 years. It was way back in September of 2014 where I met many of you as fresh-faced, wide-eyed sixth graders at Howitt. Back then, your big worry was how to open your locker or how to get to art since you had class in the other building or which cafeteria you were eating in, the east or west. I'm happy to say you all figured it out pretty quickly. Throughout my years at Howitt, I always enjoyed when seniors would come down and visit the last couple days of school. I would smile as they called me up on their high school experiences and shared what they were doing after graduation. I always thought it'd be really cool to witness that growth from freshman to senior year, and with this class, I finally got the opportunity to do just that. And let me tell you, you guys did not disappoint. In the sea of green and white robes, there are many inspiring stories of those who have overcome personal challenges to get here today. The road wasn't easy, but your unwavering determination and perseverance paid off. You did it, and we applaud you. Sadly, during this time, some of you have suffered unimaginable loss. Please know your loved ones are with us here today, and in spirit, and are very proud of you, as are we all. Over these last 4 years, I have seen many of you accomplish incredible feats, whether it be academically, athletically, or creatively. Your achievements were nothing short of extraordinary. You participated in extracurricular activities where your contributions made an incredible impact on our school community. Impressively, you served as role models for our underclassmen, leading by example and paving the way to show how to graduate with grace, style, and yes, responsibility. I'm so happy this class got to experience some of the traditional high school rites of passage, such as the Halloween parade, the prom, homecoming, banquet, and senior cut day. And by the way, just for future clarification, that's senior cut day, not days, not plural. We also created some new traditions like field day, and thanks to Abby Faber, the dunk tank, which I'm relieved I won't be sitting in for another 4 years. To my office regulars, you know who you are. I will miss you and remember to check in with Mrs. McCann and I from time to time. As I looked over the yearbook, I came across a quote that Matt DeSanti put as a senior quote. I recognized it not only because I'm a fellow fan of Rocky movies, but I also have that same quote hung in a picture above my office door. For those of you not familiar with Rocky Balboa, he's that old dude in the new Creed movies. He wears a dark blue fedora, says yo a lot, and trains Adonis. He was kind of a big deal in the late 70s and the 80s. Anyway, the quote is about the challenges of life, and it goes like this. It ain't about how hard you hit, it's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. Along your path to graduation, especially during this awful pandemic, life has given you its hits. Over these past 15 months, it's had you on the ropes, and now, where the worst is hopefully behind us, and the world thankfully is starting to regain some sense of normalcy, it's time for you to hit back at life. Set goals, work hard, make the most of your opportunities, and pursue your dreams. Always challenge yourself, and don't be afraid to take the hits. Keep moving forward. You are strong, you are bold, you are Dalers, and now you are ready. Congratulations, Farmingdale High School class of 2021. I wish you all the best.
I now would like to call Mrs. Arlene Martinez to the podium, who will introduce and honor our salutatorian.
Good evening, and welcome parents, guests, faculty, members of the Board of Education, and our esteemed guests, the 2021 graduates. It is my honor to introduce you to our salutatorian, Antonio Castano. Antonio describes his time in Farmingdale as a place where he has been surrounded by people who allowed him to explore his various interests. Antonio shared that his first teachers were his parents and his grandmother, and their various eclectic interests in carpentry, business, art, and culinary inspired him to pursue all of his interests. His passion for music began at home and was further developed in school. He became a leader in symphony orchestra and participated in various school productions such as Little Shop of Horrors and Hairspray. Antonio's interest also led him to participate in football and track and field. Academically, Antonio always excelled. He became part of various honor societies such as the National Honor Society, Tri-M, and the Italian Honor Society. Antonio was also part of Mathletes and tutored younger students. Antonio's pursuit for excellence earned him a GPA of 102.5. This fall, Antonio will continue his journey in the University of Chicago, where he will major in the molecular engineering. Please help me welcome the salutatorian for the class of 2021, Antonio Castano.
Ah, smell that beautiful summer air, am I right? To my fellow Dalers, whether you be a student, a faculty member, a parent, a resident, an athlete, or like most of us, an eclectic mix of them all, may this evening find you in good health and in better spirits. It is my honor and privilege to be able to speak to you all and my mind, live and in person, to try to impart something worthwhile unto you. A true testament to not only the inexhaustible work of our staff, but to the adaptability of the greater educational community. And for this, I am sincerely grateful. Let me begin by being frank. Like most anything in life, this was infinitely easier said than done. I find the more wise we become in life, the more stories we have to teach and ideas to disseminate, the more difficult it is to do so. So, after much deliberation, plenty of caffeine, and just enough sleep deprivation, I have decided to focus and expand upon just one topic today, and that topic is resilience. It's a nice enough word, rolls off the tongue, evoking imagery of warriors battling the elements, perils, and force majeures of the world. But this year, more than ever, we have learned that resilience is more psychological than any of us could have prepared for. This past year has taught us that there is much more to resilience than those stoic legends of Atlas and Sisyphus. No, resilience is a collective endeavor. Nobody could catch a meteor with a piece of string, but you could do it with a big enough net. Just think about it. When times got hard and we were unsure of the future, forced into solitude for the greater public health, what was the first thing we did? We talked to somebody, anybody. In times of great uncertainty, there is no better counsel than that of those close to you. Resilience, in this case, is the resistance to closing your heart from those people around you, even when doors, masks, gloves, and other barriers prevented you from physically being with them. We are fortunate enough to live in a day and age where communication is but a click away, where those who serve as our escapes, our advisors, our muses, our responsibilities, our friends, can be accessed at a finger's touch. As Nelson Mandela once said, "The greatest glory lies not in never falling, but in rising every time we fall." No singular person could rise from this pandemic alone. And if they could, they are extraordinarily rare. But put every single one of those individual people into a community, and suddenly, they all help each other rise together. When we feel like we could never triumph or prevail, and it would be easier to quit, take comfort in knowing it's even easier to pat someone else on the back, offer a hand, and tell them to keep going. After all, a phoenix can only rise from ashes. So as we dawn onto a new stage in both our academic and social spheres, let us forget not the connections we made and strengthened over this time. The chain may be as strong as its weakest link, but I can personally attest that, coming out of a global pandemic which forced the world into new and uncomfortable situations without warning, no link of the networks we made will break. Life can be strange. The future, as we know well, has a way of surprising us, no matter how hard we try to contrive its omens and auspices. The past, as we now recall it, is a powerful tool to learn from, but can also stagnate us in our pursuit of what is truly important, the present, here and now. So, speaking with the wisdom of recent history, aware of the innumerable possibilities of the future, stay resilient and stay together. While we may be separating ourselves by borderlines, housing, and for some of us, oceans, we'll always stay connected to the village that brought us up. After all, a little distance is nothing new. Congratulations to the class of 2021, and thanks to all the parents and faculty of Farmingdale for their invaluable roles in our success. Stay healthy and stay spicy.
Thank you, Antonio. Next, here to present the Dr. Gary E. Karp Community Service Award is Board of Education Vice President, Mrs. Suzanne D'Amico.
Good evening. The Dr. Gary E. Karp Community Service Award is meant to emphasize a student who demonstrates a sense of service and commitment to school or the community. This year's recipient is the embodiment of this idea. This young woman has been an ever-present part of the Farmingdale community her entire life. She was raised to do good and make the world a better place, and to do so with a smile on her face. That smile is the first thing you notice when she's standing midfield holding a flag. She has worked hard to be the best that she can be. She has also helped those around her to be the best that they can be. She has spent countless hours working with the next generation of Dalerettes to ensure the tradition of excellence continues. Within the school, she has made it her mission to ensure that every member of the student body feels included and seen. Her countless hours spent working on school events in her role as Student Government Association Vice President embodies just that. And she will bring that Daler spirit with her as she studies childhood and inclusive education. It is my honor to present the 2021 Gary Karp Community Service Award to Rachel Goldberg.
Next, I would like to invite Mr. Jed Herman to introduce our class of 2021 valedictorian.
Good evening. It is my honor today to introduce the valedictorian of the Farmingdale High School class of 2021, Mr. Christian Castle. Christian has earned this distinction by accumulating an overall and unweighted GPA of 102.83, a truly amazing accomplishment. Christian's dedication to his studies earned him awards for his participation in the Italian Honor Society, the Key Club, National Honor Society, Business Honor Society, and DECA. In addition to being a stellar student, Christian participated in winter track and both JV and varsity baseball at the high school. In the community, Christian participated in many CYO and PAL sports and worked as a PAL flag football referee, a PAL basketball referee and scorekeeper, and helped in the Youth Council Summer Rec program. It is no wonder why Christian excels at both academics and athletics. Christian describes himself as, quote, passionate about sports and competitive in nature. Quote, I thrive on competition and challenges, whether it is in school, sports, or any other activities. And I think my competitive nature is most apparent when I am on the mound pitching. Many times I am put in during pressure situations, and I always try to put my team in the best position to win. Christian says the best lesson that he's learned from sports is not wins or losses, but the friendships that helped him become the well-rounded person he is today. In summary, Christian is an amazing young man and will no doubt find great success in his future. In the fall, Christian is taking his talents to Villanova University, where he will be studying business and accounting. Ladies and gentlemen, I proudly present to you Mr. Christian Castle.
Thank you, Mr. Herman. Congratulations, Daler's class of 2021. We made it. Let's give ourselves a round of applause. I would like to welcome all of the graduates, families, friends, faculty, and distinguished guests watching virtually and present here today. It is my honor to be standing before you as your class valedictorian. Celebrating this occasion together is a blessing that most of us did not think would be possible. Thank you to Mr. Defendini, Dr. Thompson, Mr. Herman, Mrs. Martinez, board members, teachers, and staff. Your dedication, support, and guidance has been essential in ensuring that this day came to fruition. I would also like to take this time to acknowledge my family. Mom and Dad, You always provided me with the love and support that I needed. You have served as my rock, and I cannot thank you enough. I would even like to thank my brother Russell for his constant words of encouragement, such as, less with the books and more with the weights, and the classic, congrats, nerd. You all played a role in getting me to this point and helped me grow into the person that I am today. I believe it is important to acknowledge all of the parents, guardians, and family members who provided this graduating class with love and support. This day is as much about you as it is about us. Thank you and congratulations to you as well. This is not only a day of celebration, but also a day to reflect on our high school years. It feels like just yesterday that we entered the doors of Farmingdale High School as freshmen, not knowing what to expect. And now, here we are, 4 years later, as the graduating class of 2021. These years have been full of great memories, for sure. However, we were also faced with some extreme challenges, especially during this pandemic. We were confronted with virtual learning, social distancing, and mask wearing. This became the new norm. We had our share of disappointments when our sports seasons and other important events were canceled. However, we adapted and learned to appreciate the things we initially took for granted. We supported each other and came out stronger on the other side, because that is what we do as a Dalar community. I believe most will agree that when we reminisce about our high school years, it will not be focused on COVID or even on grades and test scores. What we will remember are the laughs and special memories that we shared while in class, hanging out in the commons, or attending after-school activities. We will recall the camaraderie and school spirit while cheering on our teams at the Don, especially when beating Piqua. We will cherish the relationships we built and the joy and laughter we shared together each and every day. Not only did our high school years leave us with great memories, but they also instilled in us many valuable traits. Our experiences have taught us resiliency, courage, adaptability, compassion, and they have strengthened our Dalar pride. These attributes will prove to be valuable as we embark on our next journey. Finally, I must admit, the hardest part in delivering this valedictorian speech was finding the words to say farewell to such special friends. Best wishes, good luck, stay in touch, those are all good, but they are not worthy of this graduating class. As I sat at my desk, searching for the perfect words to leave you with, I opened a graduation card from my uncle. As I read it, I realized it was exactly what I wanted to express to all of you. Be who you are. Do what you love. Make a difference. Change the world. There is no limit to what you can do, graduate. Class of 2021, I hope these words inspire you as much as they inspired me. While this is the end of a chapter in our lives, it is not goodbye, but just the beginning of a new chapter. Keep the Dalar heart and spirit alive in you. It is that which will keep us connected as a class and a community. And always remember, once a Dalar, always a Dalar. Congrats, Dalars, class of 2021. We out the jumps tonight. God bless and thank you.
Thank you, Christian. At this time, it's my honor to introduce the class of 2021 president, Emily Hunt.
Congratulations, Anna.
Good evening. I'd like to thank the administration, teachers, and family for not only being here with us tonight, but for helping to get us to where we are today. With family in mind, I'd like to give you a little information about mine. My siblings love to just share their opinions, whether I ask for it or not. But I would like to share one particular one with you. They told me, I can't wait until you get to the real world. It's gonna knock you on your, well, you know, ass. The truth is, yeah, maybe it will. But who's to say that we won't get up stronger, better, and with a new sense of purpose? The point is, you have to fail to succeed. One failure opens up new paths, highlights one way that doesn't work, and challenges the way you were thinking. This year was tough, unexpected, and forever changing. It brought about challenges and emotions we never imagined to have had. But it also showed us that when we come together as a community, we can strive for better and push our limits. We knew high school would fly, but we didn't know it would Zoom. Going against all odds, we excelled through a pandemic. Something that was supposed to be a 2-week long break turned into a 6-month long isolation. Through it all, student athletes never stopped their dedication to their sport, and artists never stopped creating. Musicians never stopped spreading joy. We broke records, created masterpieces, and spread happiness, even with the restrictions due to a pandemic. But that's not all we did. We learned how to use our voice. In the face of adversity, it was us who signed petitions, advocated, and protested for what matters most to our generation, equal rights. We know we are far from our goals, but we are a start for a better tomorrow. Sure, we certainly have our own unconventional ways of doing things, but we still get it done. Let's reflect on a minute. Something so minuscule that we turned into our greatest threat. We learned to use the power of time. 1 minute is all we need to share a common interest, make a difference, spread joy. 1 minute can cause a phenomenon of sheeshes to break out, start an addiction to whipped coffee, the ability to recite, this sentence isn't grammatically correct, but thankfully, Grammarly's here to help. Figure out if Carol Baskin was the one who killed her husband, or memorize dance moves. 1 minute is all we need to change the world. This class has a reputation of being made of the most genuine, resilient, kind-hearted, and tenacious individuals. And I believe we live up to those standards every day without any intention. So, no matter what happens next, the events we have endured will allow us to laugh at whatever the world throws at us now. Never forget that failures will push you closer to your goals. 1 minute is all you need to create change. And remember, you are braver than you think, smarter than you know, and loved more than you can imagine. To all of you, I know you will go on to accomplish amazing things. I wish you the best of luck and can't wait to see success in your future. Make the impossible possible. With peace and love, the class of 2021.
Thank you, Emily. Next to present the Board of Education Award is our Board of Education President, Mr. Michael Goldberg.
Good evening. The Board of Education Award is given each year to the student that just exudes Daler pride. This year's recipient has made the most of her years at Farmingdale High School and has enjoyed every minute. Standing on the platform, hands in the air, she has the undivided attention of the band and the crowd. We're all just watching for the distinct count to know that the performance is about to begin. As the student body president, this young woman has been the drum major for the entire building throughout the year. We have followed her lead each morning and stood to pledge allegiance, a little normalcy in this unconventional year. From PS I Love You Day to a homecoming in March, the students of Farmingdale High School fed off of her contagious energy and enthusiasm. We kept moving forward with her keeping pace. She is a leader, not because of an election or a title, but because it is just who she is. She leads, like so many great leaders, by example, and looks for no recognition. And as she heads off to study fashion merchandising, she will bring that Taylor spirit and leadership in every aspect of this next chapter of her life. It is my honor to present the 2021 Board of Education Award to Olivia Espinosa.
Congratulations, Olivia. Now I'd like to invite our Superintendent of Schools, Mr. Paul Defendini, for his message to the class of 2021.
Thank you, Dr. Thompson. In keeping with the tradition of the dozens of messages you have received from me this past year and a half, I have formatted tonight's commencement address to maintain a sense of consistency. Good evening to my Farmingdale family. This is Paul Defendini, and today is Tuesday, June 22nd, 2021. Tonight's message is intended to provide you with several important updates. The first is that for our graduates and the parents of our graduates, you no longer need to stress hearing the sound of my voice, waiting anxiously for what craziness might be coming your way in the days, weeks, or months to follow. No more updates from the state, no more changes in program, and no more school closures. The second and real purpose for tonight's address is to conclude with one final positive message. I will do my best to make it a proper end to all of your academic careers here in Farmingdale Schools that ended in a very long 16-month stretch. This final message to you tonight is about something that I say often. I say it in my daily work, I say it at home, and it is something that I frequently reminded of being a part of this great community. Tonight's message is about family. Family is a word that I do not take lightly or use flippantly, and it is not something that is easily defined. According to dictionary.com, family is defined as any group of people closely related by blood or marriage, as parents, children, uncles, aunts, or cousins. Although this may be the formal definition of the word family, here is what family means to us here in Farmingdale. Family is our students providing support to each other as they navigated virtual, hybrid, and live streaming environments these last 16 months. Family is our staff preparing and delivering thousands of meals for months on end to ensure no student went hungry. Family is our culinary program feeding 130 households during Thanksgiving holiday season, and our student body partnering with shared decision making to collect food for Island Harvest. Family is our staff sewing thousands of masks for our healthcare workers. Family is our Dalerettes, cheerleaders, pep band, and Steppendalers live streaming our homecoming pep rally to our elementary and middle school students to promote district-wide school spirit. Family is our staff working nights and weekends contact tracing to ensure students and staff were kept safe while in our care. Family is our students leading a PSI Love You Day to reinforce empathy and awareness for mental health across the district, connecting our students to social media platforms with the phrase, and I love this one, "Together we rise." Family is our staff building and rebuilding again, learning plans to care for our students and to provide for them every chance to learn and grow and to feel safe during this crazy time. Family is our staff and students maintaining their commitment to the annual senior walk tradition at our elementary schools, being role models and setting the example for our youngest children. Family is our staff making home visits to our remote learners to check on their physical and emotional well-being. Family is our students making signs and banners to show their support for our frontline workers during our shutdown last spring. And maybe most importantly, family is our car parade last spring that stretched on for miles with hundreds of cars in procession for more than 11 hours to make sure that our student body was able to physically see their teachers, administrators, and support staff. Although a bit dysfunctional at times, as is any family, we are a family here in Farmingdale. We are there for each other when it counts. In hard times, we pick each other up, dust each other off, and put each other back in the game of life. I remind our graduates that your family is not going anywhere after today. Graduation is simply the beginning of the next phase of your journey in life. Tomorrow, and every day thereafter, your Farmingdale family remains as committed to you as the day you first walked our halls many years ago. Come back and visit often to tell us about all of the feats you have accomplished and will continue to accomplish in the time yet to come. Know that if tough times befall you, we are still here to pick you up, dust you off, and put you back in the game of life. You will always be a part of our Big Daler family. Job well done. I am so happy to share the excitement of your graduation day, and I am so very proud of you. Congratulations, Farmingdale High School class of 2021. Always remember, as Christian said before, once a Daler, always a Daler. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Defendini. We will now begin the presentation of diplomas. Please watch your step as you cross, guys. Take your time, use the handrails on the stairs, and take your time on both sides.
Christian Castle. Antonio G. Castano. Olivia Espinosa. Rachel Goldberg. Adriana Cicchetti. Emily Hunt. Emma Duffy. Julia Galanek. Alexis Pham. Jennifer Dionisio. Ellie Gruska. Christina Reifert. Aaliyah Acevedo. Masroor Ahmed. Andrew Alameda. Mohsin Ali. Syed Fawad Ali. Thomas Almedina. Priscilla Almonte Cabrera. Gabriela Alvarado. Rebecca Alvarado. Can you do it on this side? Thank you so much. Sebastian Alvarez. Jonathan Amaya. Jaden Ammons. Angelina Anastasiadis. Carl Anderson. Thank you. Nicholas James Antonellis. Nicole Araujo. Dominique Argento. Dominic Arpeo. Rahib Asif. Avery Avila. Carl Bassett. Julia Badalamenti. Gianna Bakich. Nicole Ballas. Congratulations. Zenaida Barahona Moran.
Jason Tyler Barber. Tyler Christopher Barletta.
I said that. I combined the words.
Ella Barnaby. Brandon Bastian. Paul Baccio.
Brooke Bauer. Lily Bowden. Carlton Becker. Shaden Bernas. Crystal Berrios Velasquez. Sarah Basin. Isabella Bolello. Nicholas Biscardi. Carol Bitsimis. Elijah Bajonson. Jacob Blanco. Imani Brown. Matthew Block. Kaylin Bonillo. Kevin Bonner. Cassandra Bray. Sarah Brienza. Ronald Broadman III. Megan Broscrito. Brandon Brunn.
Oh, nice.
Brianna Budrim. Owen Burke. Ann Burns. Matthew Buscemi. Tyron Butler. Heather Cassace. Gianna Calandrino. Brianna Callahan. Jacqueline Congelosi. Nicole Congemi. Matthew Capolino. Paolo Capucciati. Tyler Carlo. Gina Casal. Hey. Ryan Casey. Amber Rose Castaldo. Ariana Castiglione. Ricardo Castillo. Sobeda Castro Martinez. Sarah Catanzarita. Caitlin Cavallo. Jolie Kavanaugh. Caitlin Kavanaugh. Nicole Celeste. Lillian Solari. Shawana Champani. DeAndre Nicholas Champion. Kaylee Chan.
Hello.
Jose Chandia Alfaro. Mia Chang. Edgar Chavarria. Nicole Chavarria. Derek Chavarria Fuentes. Adriana Noel Checkers. George Chen. Dominic Chiatio.
I think I mispronounced it.
Vincent Sincata. Brianna Tulo. Lauren Kalas. Samantha Comique. Haley Catherine Campbell. Alexis Condis. Courtney Paige Conklin. Jessica Erin Conklin. David Connolly. Joseph Connors. Sam Cordova. Jamie Cornejo. Anthony Cornetto. Jill Corrado. Joseph Corsi. Danielle Costello. Victoria Catone. William Crago.
Hello.
Cynthia Cruz. Paul Curcio. Julian Dabadine. Dana Caitlin. Sorry, Caitlin Dan. Sorry. Caitlin Dana. Thomas Decker.
Okay, what the heck is this?
David Davidine. Gianna Delgaze. Tyler Delgado. Michael James Delegati. Daniel DiMartino. Okay. Emma Durkoli. Anthony Diaz. Hi. Heaven Diaz. Alan DiBenedetto. Jack DiBernardo. Stephen DiCarlo.
Hi.
Graciello DiDio. Catherine Dillon. Matthew DeSanti.
My turn.
Okay.
Robert C. Dolgas.
Thank you.
Madison Dominici. Dylan Dowdikin. Jack Dunleavy. Matt Eckstein. Kate Edwards. Joseph Eleftheriadis.
I know it.
Thomas Eleftheriadis.
Thank you. You're good.
Andrew Elefante.
It's freezing. Cold.
Brooke Emmyholz. Jose Estrada.
Oh my God, hi.
Abigail Faber. Yeah. Skylar Fanzacone.
Farquharson. Yeah, I got you.
Olivia Farquharson. Amanda Favillo. Tamaya Fearington. Nicolette Fabrero. Michael Ferranti. Massimo Ferro. Matthew Kenneth Fielding. Dylan Filosa. Patrick Flanagan. Estrus Flores. Omari Ford. Cassandra Lynn Fox. Matthew Gaba. Matthew Gallo. Michelangelo Galuzzo.
Hey.
Jack Gum. Gianna Alyssa Galvez.
Was it Elisa?
Daniel Gannett!
Just to keep it in order. No, we gotta keep it in order. We have to keep them in order.
Martin Garcia!
Sorry, Martin.
Sophia Garcia Reyes! Michael Gardner! Jenny Garidi.
Thank you.
Yu Giganti. Nicholas Georgiou.
Joe Manelli.
You got this.
Grace Giovanelli.
Giovanella? All right.
Christopher Giovanello. Nicholas Gittens. Isabella Gonzalez. Christopher Gorbaran. Adam Gordon. Joshua Gordon. Rose Michelle Gordon. Anna Grandine. Stephen Granis.
I do, but did you put a middle name? No.
Jaden Grant.
I got you. I just want to make sure you didn't put a middle name.
Sean Green.
Yes, I do.
Matthew Greishaber.
I'm sorry, boss, I just Guevara. Yeah.
Gustavo Guevara. Sophia Guthrie.
Cole Hecker. Correct. Demi Hecker. I know. Gianna Heckman. Christina Helrigel. Litzy Hernandez. Thomas Hernandez. Oh. Edgar Herrera Campos. Maggie Hill. Lars Hager. Tyler Hothasol. Congrats. Kinza Hussein. Nita Husseini. Zion Hutchinson.
I know.
Matthew Hines. Alexandra Iaconis. Elvira Erzmanbetova. Isla Irvin.
Christopher Irving. Lily Jacobson. Markel Jameson. Felipe Jean. Gabriela Maria Jimenez.
I'm good.
Marissa Jones. Samantha Jones. Frederick Caden. Arian Cagiel.
Oh, shit. Where's the rest of
them?
On the other side?
Okay, Haley, waiting for Haley.
Sorry, I'm always
Congrats. Haley Keener. Jaden Keener. Shannon Kelleher. Aiden Kelly.
Congrats, man.
Emily Kelly. Kira Kelly.
Joseph
Kessler. Steven Kessler. Annika Kahn. Emily Kizalinski. Michael Anthony Kloping.
Yep.
Ashley Kretzmer. Brooke Kabelka.
Congrats.
Nicole Quas. Maggie Lafferty. Jocelyn Lanez Torres. Anthony Vincenzo Lorino.
Patrick Lee. Christian Lembo. Caitlin Lenahan. Kyle Leon. Samantha Leroy. Andre Leslie. Zoe Lee Young. Samantha Lear Kassendorf. Sharon Singh Lin. April Laquette. Alexa Jade Logan. Scarlett Lopez Meza. Brett Lopos. Johnny Los Batalier Jr. Madison Loria. Emily Lowenhop. Dominic Lucarelli. Kyle Ludwig. Arian Luthra. Richard Edward Magnini.
Magnani.
Cooper Malinowski.
Rob Malamo. Deanna Mancibo Pujols. Olivia Mangiaracina. Timothy Mansbart. Matthew Marsis. Kate Martin. Gabriella Rose Micholi. Vincent Mathias. John Matoro. Jenna Mayers. Kiara McAllister. Ariana McInnes. Tyler McGivney. Katie McKenna. Daniel McLaughlin. Lauren Mehta. Elmer Mejia. Michael Mello. Madeline Miga. Emma Milkovic. Haley Miller. Michael Miller. Talia Miller. Justin Molina. William Malloy. Jack Maloney. Spiros Thomas Maloney. Sophia Mercedes Morlea. Alexis Morales. Diego Morales. Anna Moritz. Brendan Moritz. Anthony Mora. Demi Morlatos. Sarah Monaco.
What's up? How you doing, bud?
Dominic Carmine Musara. Zipporah Muse. Serena Napoli. Jacqueline Nemesek. Leanne Nicholas. Shayna Nicholich. Crystal Noonan. Mildred Jimelet Norberto Uskanda. Jordan Olenschlager.
Opetisano.
Amanda Opetisano. Sean Opetisano. James C. Oropeza.
Madison Outing. Lewis Oswald. Victoria Palmieri. John V. Patel. Spencer Leslie Pena. Isaac Pena. William Pepitone. Christopher Peretta. Allison Patika. Joseph Petrillo Jr. Sean Petzl. Natasha May Pineda. Justin Podbilak. Michael Ponzio. Emily Portillo. Thomas Prestigiacomo. Antonio Presida. Frank Presida. Isabella Presida. Christopher Pruchnik. John Pyros. Madison Quinn. Patrick Quinn. Katia Quintanella. Yazin Robbie. Zarin F. Rahman. Sean Ramirez. Fabiana Ramirez. Lorenzo Ramos. Luis Ramos. Olivia Ramos. Trinity Ramos. Michael Ranieri. Jose Rosinos. George Reichley. Michael Ryder. Amanda Riggio. Nira Riley. Apshana Rinke. Taylor Rivas. Brianna Rivera. Jason Rivera. Madison Rivera. Nasaya Rogers. Matthew Romance. Daniel Romano. Ariane Rupshand. Nicholas Tyler Rose. Yurel Rose. Aaron Reichbach. Brady Rowe. James Rubino. Joseph Rubino III. Isabel Ruiz. Jose Ruiz.
Oh, look who it is.
Hannah Rumpf. John Seda. Patrick Seda. Gianna Marie Sensetta. Isabella Savino. Jack Scanlon. Haley Schifano. Jordan Schwartzman. Rebecca Charé. Steven Serrano. Marissa Seifert. Gabriella Mia Sferlaza. Lindsay Szymborski. Michaela Sinclair. Ani Smith. Lisa Smith. Sophia Smith. Abigail Sneed. Julia Soul. Michael Sojak. Corey Sokolowski. Saul Solis. Tyler Solis. Vincent Sotilli.
Leah Sparacio. Gianna Spataro. Dominique Spina. Taylor Spousis. No. Jacob Steele. Sydney Stewart. Dylan Suriel. Nicole Tagliavia. Haley Talbot. Pimnata Tamburak. Patrick Tarpinian. Steven Terracone. Scarlett Tavares. Christian Theranis. Robert Timmons. Matthew Tolson. Juliana Tomlinson. Elvira Torres. Robert Trietta. Brianna Tringali. Madison Trippi. Ayub Tersanzada. Jacob Tersanzada. Shalani Umana. Dennis Uraga. Christopher Vaquero. Dean Valenti. David Vasquez. Giovanna Vasquez. Laura Villatoro. Allison Virgilio. Jessica Visco. Nicholas Volker. Demetrius Vulgaris. Natalie Waddell. Hannah Wenzel. Ariana Williams. Brittany Williams. Justin Winkler.
There you go, Justin.
Olivia Weiser. Ethan Wong. Janaea Wood. Sean Zelotel. Alexa Zuniga. Kelly Zuniga.
I'd like to invite our graduates to please stand and face your families. By the power vested in me, with each senior having received a Farmingdale High School diploma, I certify to the Superintendent of Schools and the Board of Education that each member of the class of 2021 has successfully met all standards and requirements set forth by the New York State Department of Education and Farmingdale Public Schools. I ask that you now transfer your tassels from the right side to the left side, and congratulations, you are graduates. Thank you all, and congratulations again to the Farmingdale High School class of 2021. Good night.
Thank you.